Well, welcome everybody. We are very pleased. Give yourself a round of applause for making it here. Yes. How can you can't beat this day. I know it's a little warm, but a great setting, great food, Blue Angels. Maybe they'll come by again. Who knows? I'm Enrique Serna, and I'm the co-chair of the Plaza Roberto Maestas Capital Campaign. It's been my honor to be a part of all of this, and we are very happy to have all of you here in this program that we're going to have. We have a great setting. We're going to have a little bit of money we're going to get today for the project, which we're very, very thrilled about. But as we get going here, I'd like to introduce someone who's going to give us a little music. Would you please welcome Cesar Amaral?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I get the pleasure of performing a song which I wrote especially for my father and my mother. And it has a meaning behind it, which I'll get a chance to explain it to you a little bit later. Se llama Al César lo que es del César. That's my brother on the ones and twos, by the way. Thanks for my brother over here providing the sound for the event. Thank you. We're going to sing this song here for you guys. It's an original composition. We're going to start from the top here. I wanted to send a special shout out also to Valerie Saucedo and Stephen Deal, who actually put in a lot of work into organizing this event, and everybody else that's present. I see my sister's present over there as well, Roxana Amaral. We're going to start it from the top here. We're also going to get a chance to sing. We're celebrating Roberto's birthday today. We're going to get a chance to sing Las Mañanitas, and maybe we'll even do happy birthday for him too. We're going to keep it traditional. This type of music is original from Sinaloa, Mexico. It was actually brought to Mexico by Germany, believe it or not. Al César lo que es el César, así me decía mi papá, cuando miraba que su hijo tenía ganas de triunfar. Bien sabes, ya te lo he dicho, siempre lo hace recordar. Solo me das la palabra y te apoyo hasta el final. Mi madre ya está en el cielo, nunca la voy a olvidar. Los consejos que me daba para mí son especial. Soy amable con la gente y al prójimo trato a amar. La bendición en mi frente para mi meta alcanzar. ¡Échale! Y este es su compa, Julio César. La envidia suele seguirme, pero no me va a alcanzar. Al equipo que me apoya, nunca lo van a parar. Amistades son contadas y hay que saber escoger. Nunca le muerdas la mano al que te dio de comer. Yo empecé desde muy pobre y a rico quiero llegar. Solo si Dios lo permite, solo Él lo decidirá. Y al César lo que es el César, así me decía mi papá. Cuando miraba que su hijo tenía ganas de triunfar. ¡Eso! Thank you very much. I get the true pleasure and honor and privilege of introducing the woman that really needs no introduction, Estela Ortega.
Do I get hazard pay for this?
Dropping everything. How's everybody doing? Can we take this off? It's far away. So can you hear me?
Yes.
Wonderful. Well, queridos amigos y amigas, dearest neighbors, friends, familia, and a special saludos to the employees, Community Fund of Boeing. Let's give them a round of applause. I also want to acknowledge that we have El Centro de la Raza board members here with us today also, and a very dear friend of Roberto that goes back to when Roberto was in his early 20s, Russ Nelson, back here. Thank you, Russ, for being here with us. We welcome you to our home. Nuestra casa es tu casa. What a beautiful sunny day, and to see this beautiful sea of people, and of course the children that are here with us today. And also, I always have to acknowledge the loves of my life, and that is my grandchildren that are right over here. So gracias. Roberto Maestas, who was our longtime executive director and lead organizer for El Centro de la Raza, would begin his speeches with this following quote that says, "Es para los niños que trabajamos, porque ellos son los que saben amar, porque son la esperanza del mundo." It is for the children that we work, for they are the ones that know how to love, for they are the hope of the world. Again, another round of applause for our children. A little bit later in the program, you will hear what our children from Jose Marti have done, and your hearts are going to swell with joy. To the Employee Community Fund of Boeing, Kelsey Camp, Robert Malone, Judy Morrison, Elizabeth Warman, and Colette Ogle, we are eternally grateful for your immense generosity. Mil gracias, 1,000 thank yous for opening your hearts to our efforts to stabilize families with affordable housing, laying the basis for our children and youth to be successful with their dreams, creating jobs and economic opportunities, and also a space to bring all of our communities together as we are doing today. Boeing employees, you are helping us create what Dr. King referred to as the beloved community. We also want to extend our gratitude to our dear Mayor Ed Murray, Enrique Serna, Cesar Amaral, the Jose Marti children, and Joe Quintana for being with us today. Gracias por su tiempo. To our funders and donors of the development, we send you our heartfelt mil gracias. Ellen Ferguson, gracias for being here. Let us also give it up to the Boeing Corporation for sponsoring this event and providing that delicious food. Now, wasn't that great food? And esos paletas también. So when we were founded almost 43 years ago, never would we have imagined that we would be at the helm of developing such a life-changing project for our community. Back in the day when Roberto was asked by the press, "What is going to happen here at El Centro de la Raza?" And he would say, "There is going to be an explosion of creativity." That is clearly what is happening with Plaza Roberto Maestas. With the help of our community, our friends, our neighbors, that creativity has shaped Plaza Roberto Maestas. Mil gracias to all of you for that work. On a daily basis, I see our neighbors, young and old, checking out the construction, taking pictures, reading the signs as Plaza Maestas begins to take a life of its own. Once again, thank you. We will never be able to thank you enough, Employees Community Fund of Boeing. Your gift, your generosity is so important to us. Your support lends enormous credibility to our efforts to continue to raise a little over $1 million we still need to complete for the development. Siempre, siempre gracias to you. The construction is going really well, and we are on track to complete both buildings by July of next year, 2016. You now have a sense of how monumental this project is for El Centro de la Raza and Beacon Hill. It was Roberto's vision and leadership over 37 years ago that brought us to where we are here today. At the same time, Roberto would never take credit for that vision. His nature was to be collective, and he knew that it takes a community to make change, working day in and day out. Roberto Maestas, our beloved leader, often evoked the concept of Dr. King's beloved community, a community free of racism, violence, and poverty. The vision of the beloved community, his love of people, and his dedication to justice and multiracial unity continues to inspire and guide the work of El Centro de la Raza. I will end my comments with words that I read from a report that was produced by the Enterprise Foundation. I want you to envision what it will mean to the residents of Plaza Maestas when they will no longer have to choose between paying the rent and buying food. Yes. Paying the rent and keeping the utilities on. Paying the rent and filling a prescription. So envision that, how life-changing that is going to be. Gracias, gracias so much for your friendship, your love, and support. Thank you.
Thank you, Estella. By the way, the mayor was eyeing the food over there, so somebody better fix him a plate. I'm serious, get him a plate. And a paleta. All right, the mayor. We are very appreciative that Mayor Ed Murray is here today. He's a dedicated champion for civil rights and equality. And throughout his career in public service, he's been an advocate for policies that help those in need. Last year, the mayor worked to increase the minimum wage in Seattle, and he's now working toward more housing affordability through the Housing Affordability and Livability Agenda, that committee. And they recently released their extensive recommendations to address the crisis facing the city due to a lack of affordable housing. His Office of Housing was a major contributor to this project, the Roberto Maestas Project. We're very appreciative, and we're excited to have the mayor here today. Mayor Ed Murray.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. And what a beautiful Seattle day, and what an incredible story we're telling with this project. Affordable housing, so folks don't have to spend hours commuting to work. Folks can actually get on transit to get to work, where it's near facilities, where it's in a neighborhood. This is actually the vision for the whole city. And the fact that this affordable housing is happening in this neighborhood shows once again how this community and this neighborhood continues to lead the city. You know, there is a map. There's a series of maps I want to tell you about. One map's from the 1930s, and it basically shows where people of color and where lower income people live. There's another map, and it's from a couple of years ago, and it shows basically in Seattle where people of color live and where people who are struggling economically live. And guess what? The maps are identical. It's time for a change. And that's why we launched our affordability proposal. It is time not just to build affordable housing in South Seattle, it's time to build projects like this in every part of Seattle. And I hope, because we know that when kids who come from economically challenged families live in a mixed income neighborhood, they do better. It's time for those kids to be able to live in every neighborhood in the city of Seattle. It's time to change the housing map of this city from the 1930s to the 21st century. I just lost somebody's notes. And what's so great is, you know, that was Roberto Maestas' vision. And, you know, last time I was here, I talked about that Roberto used to show up in Olympia. And except for my mother, he's the only person who got by calling me Eddie. But the one time he wanted a new boiler for this building, and I was capital budget chair. And so he had the preschool kids line up and sing to me on my way to look at the boiler. But that kind of skill and that kind of ingenuity is actually why this new project is here today. Estella is continuing that skill, continuing that ingenuity about how we get things done in this city. El Central is a symbol of that. And Roberto was somebody who challenged us, but also worked for this city to get over its differences on race and economic disparity. So that's the sort of leadership we need to offer in our discussion around housing. Let's be honest about what we have, but like Roberto, let's also be honest about how we can move forward. So the city is proud to be a partner in this project. $7.9 million as part of our housing levy will go into this project. Yes. I wanted to check our numbers, but that's exactly those numbers. So Stella, thank you for your leadership. El Centro, thank you for your leadership. Let's get this project built. Let's come to the grand opening, and then let's move forward and make this whole city affordable for everybody. Thank you very much.
We're actually got a special performance from the children of Jose Marti. Yes, they have a very special performance planned for you. So we're gonna move, probably have to move the check. The camera wants to get them. So it's my pleasure to introduce to you the children, Los Niños de Jose Marti, El Futuro de Plaza Roberto Maestas, the future of Plaza Roberto Maestas. Wasn't that awesome? Now that we have the kids up here, hey, wait. You guys aren't going. Vénganse para acá. I would like their help in singing Las Mañanitas. Vamos a cantar Happy Birthday, porque me dicen que uno de ellos. Yes, get the grandchildren up here, please. The grandchildren. Todos cantan también en español. ¿Se saben las mañanitas? Sí. Oh my God, they know it. Okay, good. So we're gonna do both. Estela, can you grab that microphone there and give it to one of the children as well, so we can get that side. I'll put it this side. So we'll start with Las Mañanitas. We'd like everybody in the audience also to sing it with us. This is especially for Roberto Maestas, who would have been celebrating his birthday. Here we go. Un, dos, tres. Estas son las mañanitas que cantaba el rey David. Hoy por ser día de tu santo te las cantamos a ti. Despierta, mi bien, despierta. Mira que ya amaneció, ya los pajarillos cantan, la luna ya se metió. Happy birthday to you,
cha cha cha.
Happy birthday to you,
cha cha cha.
Happy birthday,
Roberto.
Oh my God, amazing. Thank you.
Si se puede, si se puede, si se puede, si se puede, si se puede.
They're taking over, man. They're taking over. Oh my, I would really hate to be the people in the program following up those cute children. Who's next? Actually, it is me. That's amazing. And that's why Roberto Maestas used to always say they are the hope of the world. I did this exercise, and I'd like you guys to respectfully ask you to do it with me. I did this exercise at our Plaza Roberto Maestas planning meeting a couple months ago. And this event was one of the things that came out of that exercise. So I'd like each and every one of you in the audience, if you could please close your eyes with me. If you're sitting in the sun, enjoy that sun, how it feels, because it'll be gone soon. And if you're sitting in the shade, you're lucky. I'd like you to think about this word with me, and it is freedom. Freedom is blank. Freedom is blank for Estela Ortega. Freedom is blank for Mayor Murray. I got a good feeling that freedom for Roberto Maestas was this big, beautiful building right behind me and that construction project that's going on. Every man has a purpose, and it is the knowing of that purpose which enables every soul to fulfill it. You can open your eyes now. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my parents' freedom. My parents and my sister and my brother and myself, we were Mexican immigrants in the late 1980s who came to Seattle looking for that American dream. Looking for freedom. And it took me a long time to really start thinking about how my parents could get up every single morning, very early, leave the house, and come back very late for minimum wage, day in, day out. And I started thinking about it, and I asked my dad, as this thing comes down on me. It dropped earlier. Dad, why did you go to El Centro de la Raza when we first came to the United States? Why did you go to El Centro? Because I heard that El Centro had given us Christmas gifts when we didn't have any money. But I knew there was a reason. There was a more specific reason than to get Christmas gifts. And my dad said, because our freedom was to give our three children the opportunity to get an education. So when they first arrived to the United States and didn't speak English, somebody said, go to El Centro de la Raza, and they can show you where to send your kids to school. They can show you that path. My older brother graduated from high school, went on to study at South Seattle Community College, and now is a manager at the Promenade Red Apple in the Central District. My younger sister, who's also in the audience, went on to graduate high school, got her bachelor's degree at the University of Washington, and got her master's degree in education at City University. And now she's an educator. She was Roberto Maestas' executive assistant for some time. Now she's an educator at Denny Middle School. And a board member of El Centro. Myself, I also graduated high school, and I went to the University of Washington and got a bachelor's degree in jazz studies. So something went wrong with me. I decided to pursue music. So I did spend time in the banking industry for about 10 years of my life. My dad was always supportive. He's a musician himself. And he said, Cesar, if you want to study music, you go study music. I support you 100%. However, I would also recommend that you have a day job because it's very difficult to make it in the music industry. So I went on, and after I got my degree at the University of Washington, I did banking for 10 years. Most recently was an assistant vice president at one of the top 20 banks in the country. That did not give me my freedom. So I went in search of my freedom in August of last year. And I said in that very room, hey guys, I just resigned from my job. And Estella said, wow, that's amazing. What do you have lined up? I'm gonna go in search of my freedom. I've always wanted, ever since I was one of those little kids at the Jose Marti, I always wanted to be a professional musician, and I always wanted to help people. So that's what I'm in search of now.
I first met Roberto Maestas 25 years ago when I was writing a magazine story about the lack of a radio here in Seattle area. There's sort of one now in South Park, but at the time there wasn't. And Roberto and I talked about that and many other things. And he really wanted to take El Centro to the next level, to create the beginnings of a radio right here. Not just a place to go for services or childcare, but something you could live and work and shop and be at, a real home for Seattle's Latinos. We didn't share much in common beyond that in our Southwest roots. He was from New Mexico, I was from West Texas, and he was he loved basketball, and so did I. Now, if any of you have ever played basketball with Roberto or seen him in action, you know it was like playing with a rat terrier. I mean, he clawed, he scratched, he climbed on your back, he talked smack nonstop, and if you so much as touched him, he called a foul on you, you know? But he laughed the entire time. He just loved the sheer joy of it. And that's the way he was, and everybody who ever encountered him knows it. He just loved life, and he loved people. Because we were different in every other way. Our politics were different. He dressed like he'd just coming for the revolution. I dressed, well, like this. Our social circles were different and so on. But for 25 years, we maintained our friendship. Because to me, Roberto was the living embodiment of Martin Luther King's dream. He didn't care about how you looked or the color of your skin. Roberto Maestas cared about the content of your character. And he was a great man for that. And so it's only fitting that Plaza Roberto Maestas be named after him.
Thank you very much. Thanks for those stories. I'm sure there's a million stories about Roberto that we could all share. So with that, we'd like to just conclude. I said there was a meaning behind Al César lo que es del César. The reason why Al César lo que es del César is a saying, is a common saying in Spanish for people named César, like myself. So my dad used to always say that, and for me, that's him confirming, him always, his support, and him confirming that I would find that I would find my true passion, that I would find that purpose. So I'd like to sing it for you once again. We're going to do this song one last time, and after that, we'd like to invite you to each take a hard hat tour. If you haven't signed up for one yet, please do. You do need closed toe shoes. Yeah, I think I can go with these boots. I think it's fine. Okay, viene, échale, compa. Thank you guys. Yeah, you guys can all dance too. Yeah. Thanks to everybody from Boeing for coming out and making this a very special event. Thank you. Enrique. Thank you. Al César, lo que es del César, así me decía mi papá, cuando miraba que su hijo tenía ganas de triunfar. Bien sabes, ya te lo he dicho, siempre lo hace recordar. Solo me das la palabra y te apoyo hasta el final. Mi madre ya está en el cielo, nunca la voy a olvidar. Los consejos que me daba para mí son especial. Soy amable con la gente y al prójimo trato a amar. La bendición en mi frente para mi meta alcanzar. Y viva Estela Ortega, viva, viva el centro de la raza, viva. Viva Plaza Roberto Maestas, viva. La envidia suele seguirme, pero no me va a alcanzar. Al equipo que me apoya, nunca lo van a parar. Amistades son contadas, y hay que saber escoger. Nunca le muerdas la mano al que te dio de comer. Yo empecé desde muy pobre, ya rico quiero llegar. Claro, si Dios lo permite, solo Él lo decidirá. Y al César, lo que es del César, así me decía mi papá, cuando miraba que su hijo tenía ganas de triunfar. Thank you very much to Estela. Thank you for el centro de la raza. Estela, could you please come up and do the famous Viva? Please. I try to do it, but I don't do it justice. Please, Estela. This is a participation. And after this, please sign up for a hard hat tour.
Okay, so this is in the tradition of Roberto Maestas. And so when I say Viva, whatever, you in the loudest voice say Viva. So can you do that? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, all right. Viva Roberto Maestas!
Viva!
Viva Plaza Maestas!
Viva!
Viva los employees de Boeing!
Viva!
Viva la comunidad!
Viva!
Gracias. Go and have a wonderful day, and we hope this was memorable to you. Thank you.
There's also birthday cake over here if anybody wants.